mist coming in, like something is brewing and about to begin. Can't put my finger on what lies in store, but I feel what's to happen all happened before. A father, a mother, a daughter, a son, the threads of their lives are all raveling undone. Something is needed to twist them as tight as a string you might use when you're flying a kite. Chim chimney, chim chim, chari chim charu.
Good morning, Bert.
Good morning, Miss Lark. And how's little Willoughby doing today?
Very well, thank you, Bert. Willoughby.
By Jove! Is that the beauteous Miss Lark I spy on the horizon?
Oh, Admiral! Willoughby!
Morning, Admiral. How's it looking?
Dark clouds gathering at number 17. Storm warning's overdue.
Of all London's byways where I doffs me cap, this one's the hardest to find on the map. Cherry Tree Lane, as sweet as a song, but the nannies who come here, they don't stay for long. Chim chimney, chim chim, cherry chim chow.
The children when there's no nanny in the house. Me, that's who.
I said I'd stay with them for the next all day. I'm done with this house forever.
Well, good riddance then, and mind you, stumble on your way out.
Katie Nana, where are you going? Katie Nana!
By your children's pranks.
Do you really think I made another blunder? What on earth am I to say to Mr. Banks? George, dear, I'm feeling so bereft, dear. Another nanny's left.
Precision and order, that's all that I ask for. But in a love household, a straightforward task, the children, the servants, are all your domain. The styrofoam, the sovereign, a cherry tree lane.
Coat. Simple truth is you engaged 6 nannies in the past 4 months, and they've all been unqualified disasters.
A nanny should govern, a nanny should rule. Who suffers no fool. When nanny's a starward, our children would gain by having such a nanny in Cherry Tree Lane.
Of course, George, but...
So take control of situations. Show your authority with interviewing staff. You know their role, they know their stations. Efficiency and forethought cut the jobs in half. Briefcase.
I thought Katie Nana would be firm with the children. she always looks so cross.
Winifred, never confuse efficiency with a liver complaint. Umbrella.
If only we could find someone like your old nanny.
I'm afraid that's just not realistic, my dear. Human lives demand as Miss Andrews' standards of efficiency. Besides, you can never afford someone of the caliber.
Army barracks.
Yes, we're in the mess. Wonder the nanny's heart will want it
We're living in a madhouse
in Cherry Tree Lane.
You know what to do, George?
Very well. Then place an advertisement in the Times stating that Jane and Michael Banks require the best possible nanny the lowest possible wage. I would stress that.
Father?
What's that you're holding, dear?
We bring our own advertisement.
What on earth?
George, please. I think we should hear it.
Now, Winifred, none of these theatrics.
It won't hurt to listen.
One day, will you please go upstairs and let me get to work?
They were only trying to help.
Won't help anyone to make me late. Where's my hat?
George, dear.
Hat.
Hat. I thought you put it down here.
Hat.
I'm sure a bowler hat can simply.
Place an advertisement. Not yet.
George and Winifred Banks live here, do they not?
Mr. and Mrs. Banks live here, yes.
And you are looking for a nanny?
I suppose.
Very well, then. Now, let's see. Play games, all sorts, which I most certainly can. Take us on outings, give us treats.
Michael, it's our advertisement!
rosy cheeks and fairly pretty. There's no objection on that score, I hope.
Not at all.
I'm glad to hear it.
But take it up with Mrs. Banks. She manages all those sort of things. Nothing domestic has anything to do with me. And don't forget the references.
I make it a rule never to give references.
But I thought it was usual.
A very old-fashioned idea to my mind. The best people now never require them.
Oh, I see. You'll have every third Thursday evening off from 5 until 9.
The best people get every second Wednesday, 6 till late, ma'am. And that is what I shall take.
Oh. Well, I guess it's all settled then.
As long as I'm satisfied. I will see the children now, thank you.
Of course. You'll find them very nice children. Now, this is... Oh.
Mary Poppins. Jane, don't stare. And close your mouth, Michael. We are not a codfish. Best foot forward. Spit spot.
Mrs. Brill, we have a new nanny.
She passed her interview then?
Or I did.
If there's one thing I appreciate, it's a child whose words I can depend on. Who's she when she's at home?
That's Valentine. She's mine.
From the look on her face, I'm not sure she'd agree with you.
Well, she's just a doll, and I don't want to play with her right now.
Treat her like that, and she might not want to play with you. Now, first things first, I always say the proper place to hang a hat is on a hat stand.
There's nothing in it.
We better keep an eye on this one. She's tricky.
Mary Poppins, how could you know what we wanted in a nanny when we made our list?
Your list? Not an item on the weekly shop, thank you very much. The plan's pretty tricky.
Very tricky.
Well, how did you come then? It's as if the wind just blew you here.
It did. Now, stand over there. Ah, just as I thought. A noisy, mischievous, troublesome little boy.
You're making that up.
A noisy, mischievous, troublesome...
Thank you.
short-tempered and untidy.
I don't believe you. Let me see.
By the time the wind has blown the weatherman around, I'll show you if I can. No matter what the circumstance, for one thing I renown, my character is spit spot spick and span.
What about your measurements, Mary Poppins?
I'm practically perfect.
Practically perfect.
does what I likes, and I likes what I do. Today I'm a Scriver, and as you can see, a Scriver's an artist of highest degree. And it's all my own work, from my own memory.
Oh, Lummy! Not these again!
Come on, Mr. Parkkeeper. It's just my pictures like it always is. There's no harm, no.
I'll be the judge of that. This is my park, and I say you're interfering with a public railing. I want them gone. This. You watch it. That's all. You watch it.
Stay right where you are. I know that silhouette anywhere. Mary Poppins!
Nice to see you, Bert.
Well, I must say, you do look swell.
I wasn't born 1 minute before I arrived at your house, Michael Banks. Have you met these two birds?
I've seen them running about, chasing a kite.
It isn't a real kite.
So, what are you up to?
Mary Poppins says it's a game. It's called a walk in the park.
Some game. I'd rather spinach.
Come on, Bert. You're due for a break, and you promised me you'd take me out when we met again. Or have you forgotten?
Of course I ain't, Mary. But...
Oh dear, is that all you've got? Never mind, my treat. And no one's charging for the trees in the sky now, are they?
Mary Poppins, is he really coming with us?
Why shouldn't he?
Well, to start with, he's very dirty, isn't he? Father would never approve.
What's that?
You can't come with us. You're too dirty, and we don't want to go to the stinky park anyway.
Oh, yes you do. Because when you go walking with Mary Poppins, you go places you never dreamed of. And if she says it's a game, she's got something in mind. You can be certain of that.
That's a picture of the park, isn't it?
No, it isn't. Not our park, anyway. Look, the trees are much brighter green and the sky is quite a different blue.
I think you'll find it's just the way I've drawn it. All that it takes is a spark. Then something, plain as a park, becomes a wonderland. All you have to do is look anew, then you'll understand why it's a jolly holiday with Mary. Mary makes your heart so light.
Oh, really?
When the day is gray and ordinary, Mary makes the sun shine bright.
You do talk nonsense, Bert.
Oh, happiness is blooming all around her. The daffodils are smiling at the dove.
I haven't even seen what you're talking
about. When Mary holds your hand, you feel so grand. Your heart starts beating like a big brass band.
You've got enough brass for all of us.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. No wonder that it's Mary that we love. Come on, you two.
Holiday
with Mary. never known.
You can ask the passing statuary.
Nothing's ever set in stone.
Born and handsome.
You look tip-top, I may say so, Mary.
Thank you, Bert, as you may.
Each man up with his dog will stand agog to see us dead to take a gentle jog.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary.
No wonder that it's Mary that we love.
It's a jolly holiday in Cuba. Gentlemen like you are few. Though you're just a diamond in the rougher, underneath your blood.
I knew we should have trouble when you came here, and now we've got a statue missing. Oh, Lummy!
Will you play with us again, Nelius?
Well, it's not like I'm going anywhere.
Then we'll see you soon.
Goodbye, children.
Goodbye, Nelius! Nelius must be so lonely. Could his father ever come to stay?
Any happen if you let it.
How long will you stay?
We'll see.
You won't leave us, will you, Mary Poppins?
I'll stay till the wind changes. Now run along with you two.
Good night, Jane. Good night, Michael. Good night, Mary.
Good night, Bird.
Tell them you've given me...
George, please. Oh, Daddy, we've had a fantastic day. We sang with the busker, danced with the statue, and met Queen Victoria. You would have approved, but...
Then why would you do it?
Daddy, can I have a kite, a proper one?
Could you fly it?
You could always teach me.
When would I have the time to do that?
Daddy, who is the father of Amelia?
Could you please let me get on? Good night.
Poor Michael. All he cares about is flying kites. And his beloved astronomy, of course.
I used to love astronomy his age. My nanny, Miss Andrews, soon beat it out of me.
I suppose we do need a nanny. It is out of the question to do without one.
Don't be absurd. Of course we need a nanny. All of the best people have nannies. So the wives can do charity work and entertain. Which reminds me, how's your tea party coming along?
Oh, I don't know. It seems so odd to send out invitations to people I hardly know.
But they're people you should know. Remember, by your friends shall ye be judged.
But that's the point. They're not my friends. Actually, I heard today from Clemmy Bunting. She's rehearsing a new play at the moment, and I thought I might ask her.
How many times must I tell you? I wish you to sever all connections with that part of your life.
George, I was an actress. Lots of people might find that interesting, but you always talk as if I should be ashamed of it.
Well, it's not exactly something to be proud of. Winifred, dearest, I'm only thinking you. I want people to admire you, respect you.
I know, George, but sometimes it's hard.
It's not hard. It's your job, to be Mrs. Bex.
And what is your job?
To pay for everything. What is it?
I was only going to kiss you.
Oh, all right. You gonna say something to Mary Poppins about this afternoon?
I don't think so.
Very well. Just make sure she's doing things our way, not hers. What good are rules? If you can bend them. We need a nanny who is disciplined and stern. With boys and girls, we don't befriend them. I fear that Mary Poppins has a lot to learn.
Being Mrs. Banks should be an easy role, and yet it's one which I don't see. I have a comfy home, I have a simple life, I have a name which tells the world I'm someone else's wife. Being Mrs. Banks, what does that entail? Facing tests of character, I always seem to fail. And as for his best people, well, I'd like to say, no thanks, they're not exactly my idea of being Mrs. Banks. I still feel as if I'm dreaming so much
tides can turn, sink or swim. See what you learn. Me, I was told when I was small, just learn a trade. So I learned them all. Chim, chimini, chim, chim, so read.
Morning, Bert. Swamping the decks today, I see.
Gotta keep the streets ship-shape, Admiral.
Tell me, how are things aboard number 17? All plain sailing with Mary Poppins, I trust.
There's rough weather on every voyage, Admiral.
Ah, Miss Lark, what these children need is a touch of the cannon and a night on the yon yard.
What these children need, Admiral, is a touch of happiness. Willoughby!
Before the guests arrive.
Everything's under control, ma'am.
And what about the cake?
Cooling on the tray, waiting to be iced.
And you're quite sure you know how to ice it?
Quite sure. And in case you're worried, I have not been exchanged by the fairies for a total nincompoop.
No.
No.
Well, I'll just go up and check the drawing room.
I'd like to be helpful.
And I'd like to be rich, but the good Lord thought otherwise. Well, she can't have me. I've got enough of my plate as it is.
She says you can tell Roberts and I what to do.
Does she indeed? Well, why don't I go and have a smoke near the gas works for good measure?
Please, Miss Brill. I don't mind. Honest.
All right. I will give you one task and one task only. And so help me, if you get this wrong, I'll swing for you and sing as they pull the lever.
What is it, Miss Brill?
Put the icing tools next to the cake. And I'll need a bowl of hot water to warm them. I will make the icing as soon as I'm back.
Icing tools, cake, hot water. I will make the icing as soon as I'm back.
How do you think you can manage that?
Is that all?
For you? Yes. For me? No. I have the sandwiches next because Madam wants them fresh, so I can't start them until there's hardly any time to finish them. I swear, a slave in nature roams and a pleasure cruise has been of my life in this house.
Well, don't just stand there, Roberts and I.
Right. No.
What are you looking for?
A bowl for the water.
Michael, why don't we just make the icing?
Because we don't know how.
Don't be so feeble. Get me the eggs. If Mrs. Brill can do it, it can't be that hard.
Are there eggs in icing?
There are in mine.
I don't think Miss Brill will thank you.
Then she will be guilty of great ingratitude. Get me the cake.
I don't believe it's supposed to look like that. It doesn't look like that when Miss Brill makes it.
Don't be impertinent and get me the cake.
Honest, Miss Jane, I was just trying to be helpful. If you would just...
Yeah! Eddie, now, what have you done? Roberts and I? Roberts and I? Oh, dear, should I call a doctor?
I don't think that will be necessary.
How can you be so unkind when you know how important my party is? We're going to get some very... nasty medicine. Just you wait till bedtime.
Oh, I don't think we should wait till then, ma'am. Why not go up and get changed? We'll clear up here now, won't we?
But we're not ill. I won't take it, and you can't make me.
And that has in so many things your information is missing. Open.
But it's strawberry ice.
Now you.
I'm not sure I like strawberry ice.
I'm not sure I care. Open.
Lime cordial!
Now off we go, you two. Michael, I know you like to keep things neat. Jane.
I told you she was tricky. Leslie, can't Roberts and I do it when he wakes up? He is a servant.
With that attitude, you'll go through a lot of staff before you're very old. Besides, in every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun and snap, the job's a game. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake. A lark, a spree, it's very clear to see that
Really? have dreams of power and position, and it's our job to back them to the hilt. For shrewd investment and advice, they'll pay our price. The bedrock on which base our bills.
Banks, a word. I see Arab and Hustler is coming in again today. Have you made your decision?
I believe so, sir.
Good, good. Be sure it's the right one. Hustler, what I haven't been able to grasp is what exactly is your final product?
Money, of course.
Yes, money. What a wonder. Making money out of money. Is that enough?
Are you man enough to be a banker?
A man has dreams of building an empire to make it in many distant lands. And it's a new world, I am told, will soon strike more. Let's seize that chance with both hearts.
I know that.
Give us a chance, you won't regret it. The factory could be running in weeks and spending 40 years out. Please, Mr. Banks. I give everything I've got. Believe me.
I do believe you, Mr. Northbrook. And I've tried to find a way, but there's simply just not the collateral.
What about my workforce? These men who want better lives? They're my collateral. My men have dreams to earn an honest living. Wife and kids, a home to call their own. If you'd invest in us today, it pays the way. I promise we'd repay the loan.
I'm sorry, Mr. Northbrook, but I don't think any... What on earth are you doing here? Can't you see I'm busy?
No, we're done. And no man should ever be too busy for his own children. Why are you here, young man? Have you come for some money as well?
Hardly. What would they need money for?
It's never too early to learn its value.
I know the value of this. Sixpence.
No, that's its worth. Its value's in how you spend it. Do good and may you have good luck.
And what do you say to Mr. Northbrook?
Thank you!
I'll wait outside.
What does it mean to this? Really, Mary Poppins? I'm not without a sense of humor, but...
You, Daddy?
No, I'm not. But when I was a little boy, I wouldn't have dared interrupt my father.
Were you ever a little boy?
Of course I was. But my nanny, Miss Andrew, kept me out of my father's way. And she would have been very annoyed if she hadn't.
What about your mother?
I shouldn't think I saw either of them more than once a week.
Didn't they mind?
Mind? They were glad to be rid of me.
Well, who kissed you goodnight, Miss Andrew?
Certainly not. There are no times for hugs and kisses and all that soppy nonsense. What's the matter?
Poor Daddy.
Poor? What do you mean poor? That's what made me the man I am today, eh, Mary Poppins?
Yes, I'm afraid it did.
It's quite enough. You've seen where I work, and I have a great deal to do.
Daddy, when you invest in the bank's money, what are you looking for? A good idea.
I suppose I should say a good idea. But a good man is much rarer and much more valuable.
Come along now, children.
Mr. Northbrook, I consider your ideas, but I'm afraid my answer is no.
Sir, don't you recognize a good idea, son?
Perhaps not. But I recognize a good man when I see one.
You will regret this, Herr Banks.
Exactly, can the factory open?
Thank you, sir. You won't regret it.
Say. Well, here she is now. You can tell yourself.
Isn't that Miss Lark's dog, Willoughby?
Don't interrupt when someone's barking. You were saying? Really? Well, if she keeps wandering off, perhaps it would be better off to keep her on the lead. Ah, look, here she comes now.
Willoughby! It's all right. Mommy's here. You know, sometimes you don't think you can talk.
Of course he can. Getting him to stop is the problem.
How do you learn to talk dog?
How do you think? Master the grammar.
Practice when you can.
And avoid mongrels.
Bah, too much slang.
Now, come along, children. I can't stand here all day talking shop.
Talking shop? What a silly expression.
There's nothing silly about it in the least.
What do you buy at a talking shop?
Conversations, of course.
Well, I've never seen a talking shop.
Well, there's only one, and it belongs to Mrs. Corey.
Who's Mrs. Corey?
Who's Mrs. Corey? Mrs. Corey is older than anyone in the world. She talked to William before he went conquering, to Vlad before he went impaling, and to Alexander when he went so great.
We'll have to call it a shop in the park.
There's no shop in the park.
Remember, anything can happen if you let it.
That's it. I've run out of conversations.
Good day to you, Mrs. Corey.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Mary Poppins.
With Jane and Michael Banks.
She knows us?
And how is poor little Georgie?
Who?
George Banks, your father. He used to give his nanny the slip and come into my shop here in secret.
But it can't be the same George Banks. That was 40 years ago. And no one can remember back that far.
Listen, dearie, I remember everything.
I remember George used to love my gingerbread. I wonder if we got any luck today.
Annie, Fanny, look lively.
Yes, Mother.
There you are. Gingerbread pieces with gingerbread stars. Georgie always saved his stars. Now, Mary Poppins, what can I do for you?
Well, I did want an ounce of conversation.
I'm all out of conversations, and I'm right out of words, too.
You see, we've had a lot of chatter boxes in here today. But let me see what you can do.
Ooh! We do have some letters and a little bit of back chat. An ounce, you say?
That'll be 15 letters. Go on, take your pick.
Jane, you can go first. 2-7.
I've got D, G, R, U, C, L, and I. Those are no good. You can make a conversation out of that.
Your turn, Michael. 7 more.
I've got A, F, S, E, T, O, and P.
And I'll choose an X. Now, what words can we make?
I see dog and cat.
Rotoplex, that's 9.
Lepidopterus, that's 11. Nearly there.
Those don't count. You made them up.
And where do you think words came from in the first place? Someone had to make them up.
You know, you can always use the same letter more than once. Now, let me see. Super, calic, fragilistic, expialidocious!
That's not a word.
Of course it's a word. And unless I am very much mistaken, I think it's going to prove a rather useful one. When trying to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leaf through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity conversation keen. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Supercalifragilistic, expialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, don't always sound precocious. Supercalifragilistic, expialidocious.
They might have used it once or twice.
I'm sorry, dips and barrels would have grasped it in a dip. Then every single pair of feet would bear his line of a
rope. Oh, so you had a friend who listened, and the other ones were not so precocious. Had some buzz flourishes, it's pseudococcocious. Supercalifragilistic, expialidocious.
have carved on their mighty monoliths.
The ancient Greeks have used it in. I'm sure the Roman Empire only entered the abyss because those Latin scholars never had a word like this.
Breath before you speak in case it's halitosis.
Yeah. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
You know, you can always say it backwards. Which is supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
She may be tricky, but she's bloody good.
So when the cat has got no tongue, there's no need for dismay. Just summon up this word and then you've got a lot to say.
Pick out those 18 consonants and 16 vowels as well. Then put them in an order which is very hard to spell. Thank you.
foot those steps there and stand back.
You are never to come near that vase nor anyone else but me neither. This is an heirloom.
Heirloom.
And while I do this, stay totally immobile.
Immobile.
Do not move a muscle.
Muscle.
Do not breathe, do you hear me?
I might as well be dead.
Don't give me any ideas.
Game is played, a change is made, but still the road is long. And though they might yet fly a kite, sometimes the wind's too strong.
George, what's happened? Are you ill?
No. Should I be?
Of course not, only why on earth are you home so early? Is everything all right?
No. Things are wrong.
My dear, what is it?
If you must know, I refused a German chap alone. He went to our chief rivals and they gave him the money. Now it's turned into a gold mine.
Well, they can't expect you to get it right every time.
Can't they? That's exactly what they expect.
Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough.
That is more than loud enough. Upstairs now.
But we were just.
I don't care what you were just. Upstairs now. Where's my briefcase, Michael? Jane, will you give it to me? Must I put up with this? You're their mother. Why don't you do something about it?
I can try not yelling for a start.
Mary Poppins, you're supposed to be teaching them manners, and look at them. They're a pair of little savages. If it was up to me, be out
George,
of this house.
You're tired. Don't bring the children down tonight, Mary Poppins. Mr. Banks is quite exhausted. Perhaps you could keep them occupied.
I hope you haven't forgotten. Can I play?
Evening off.
What?
Oh dear, I had forgotten. I suppose the best people wouldn't ask you to change your plans.
No, ma'am, they wouldn't.
I thought not.
It's not fair. Daddy loses his temper, and we're shut up in the nursery. Daddy's mean and rotten, and I hate it.
Jane, take that back this instant. I will not have you criticize your father.
But he criticizes you. Last week he said you're neither use nor ornament.
How dare you?
I heard him say it, and so do you.
Sometimes people say things they don't mean. Take the children upstairs, please, Mary Poppins. George?
What is it?
I thought you might like to talk about it.
Don't be ridiculous.
Perhaps I can help.
What would be the point?
I'm serious, George. If you have troubles, I'd like to share them.
Don't worry. You will. The fact is, I've been suspended without salary until the bank decides what to do with me. And turns, ups and downs, one moment smiles, next moment frowns, but bad-tempered faces had better change quick, cause if the wind changes, the face just might stick. Chim chimity, chim chim, chari chim charu.
Plenty of toys to play with.
I don't want to. They're boring.
They might say the same about you.
Why does Daddy get so cross?
Fathers are supposed to look after their children, not yell at them all the time.
Maybe, but have you asked yourself who looks after the fathers when things go wrong?
The mothers, I suppose.
Not the children?
Wouldn't that be rather upside down?
Sometimes families are upside down, for a while anyway.
I don't want to be in an upside down family. I wish I could just run away.
Why don't you? Someone might adopt you.
But you'd miss me.
No, I wouldn't. I could have your toys.
No, you could not.
Yes, I could, and I jolly well would.
Give her back to me. Now look what you've done.
That's no way to treat poor Valentine. What has she ever done to you?
She's a doll, silly. She can't do anything.
That'll be all, you two. Now into bed, at once.
But we haven't had our milk.
There'll be no buts, and no milk either. If you can't be good, you may as well be sorry.
I wish you would just leave us alone.
Be careful what you wish for. Poor Valentine. Go inside and make yourself presentable.
I'm not going to bed and you can't bake me.
In that, as in so many things,
your information
is faulty.
Thank you.
is all billowed and curled. Between pavement and stars is the chimney sweep's world. Where there's hardly no day, nor hardly no night. There's things half in shadows and halfways in light. On the rooftops of London. Whew! What a sight. Best view in the world, eh? You get to see it. The birds, the stars, and the chimney sweeps. Nothing to be today. Now as the ladder of life has been strung, you may think us sweeps on the bottom most rung. Though I spend me time in the ashes and smoke, in this whole wide world there's no happier bloke. Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim chimney, a sweep is as lucky can be. Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim chimney, good luck will have when he shakes hands with you. Or blow me a kiss,
bird,
and that's lucky too. So you're off then.
The wind has changed.
But they're good kids, Mary.
But I'd be bothered with them if they weren't. But I can't help them, they won't let me. And there's no one so unchanged as a child who knows everything.
So?
So, they've got to do the next bit on their own.
Chim chimani, chim chimani, chim chimani. When you're with the sweep, you're in glad company. Nowhere is there a more happier crew than them's what sings chim chim chari chim charoo. Chim chimai chim chim chari.
Thank you.
secret.
Some
truly am. I really thought it was gonna be, you know, her with the umbrella.
Michael, what are we gonna do?
The only thing we can do, run away!
You've been through enough of them. Is she really as bad as all that?
She looks like something that would eat its young.
Cassandra was Daddy's old nanny,
which explains a lot.
Poor Daddy. Ever since he stopped working, he just sits and mopes. Mary Poppins used to say we could help him, but now it's too late.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. I'll tell you what. Why don't we start things off with a bit of a shake for good luck?
Why would shaking hands with you bring us luck?
Didn't anyone ever tell you it's lucky to shake a sweep's hand?
What do you do when you need some luck?
Oh, well, I shake hands myself. Now, what do we have here?
Michael, look, it's a real one. What's wrong? You've always wanted to fly a proper kite.
I've always wanted to fly one with Daddy.
Of course you have, but you need to know how it's done first. Get some training in, and you'll make him the proudest father in the country.
Really think so? You're not just saying that?
Did I say country? The whole blooming empire, more like. With tuppence and paper as strings, you can have your own set of wings. With your feet on the ground, you're a bird in flight, with your fist holding tight to the string of your kite. Oh, let's go fly a kite up to the highest heights. Let's go fly a kite and send it soaring up through the atmosphere, up where the air is clear. Oh, fly a kite.
Try again.
What's this? I don't allow litter in my park.
It isn't litter. It's a kite.
Oh, a kite, you say? My word, it is a kite. I haven't flown a kite since I was a boy. Now, we'll wind her up, give her a run, and away she'll go.
I want to play.
Oh, but surely you'll let me help, seeing as I haven't flown a kite since I was a boy.
When you send it flying up there, all at once you're lighter than air. You can dance on the breeze over houses and trees with your fists holding tight to the string of your kite. Oh, let's go. Up to the highest height, let's go fly a kite and send it soaring up through the atmosphere, up where the air is clear. Oh, let's go fly a kite.
Now let's go home. And don't dawdle.
We can't. She's there. She came as a surprise for Daddy.
Did she? Well, maybe I'll be a surprise for her. That was a lovely greeting, Bert.
I meant it, Mary. Welcome. You're a sight for sore eyes.
You really are. Welcome back, Mary Poppins.
I told you they were good kids, Mary.
And I told you they were worth bothering with.
Now, see here. It's against the regulations coming from the sky like that. And where from, I'd like to know. Where from?
If I were a park keeper, I would straighten my cap and button my coat. Now, come along, children.
Aren't you going to shake hands with Bert for good luck?
No.
Why not? We have.
I don't need any luck, thank you.
Burden.
yes, of course.
That's the field I know. Seeing a lark in a cage for the first time and the last. My pleasure. Oh, don't mention it.
Hey, I want to see this.
I'm going downstairs to fetch Caruso, my lark. You stay there and clean the grates again. So, we've decided to come crawling back, have we? Well, I think we know what this calls for.
Notice.
I see. And what do you expect me to do?
Pack.
Pack! Insolent young lady, how dare you speak to me this way?
Silly little girl, with your new fangled methods, I bring up children so they know their place. Starting from tradition, I govern my charges.
Charges blow up in your face.
I brought up their father. Well, then I don't doubt you must be so proud of the way he's led out.
A shiny example, a pillar of light.
They all have their problems, but him more than most.
Caruso? Where is Caruso? Where has he gone?
very naughty to go running off like that. I should be as angry as anything if I weren't so pleased to see you. Where's Miss Andrew?
She's gone.
Gone? Why?
She didn't give a reason, ma'am.
How peculiar. So, Mary Poppins, if you're back, are you going to stay?
I'll stay for as long as necessary, ma'am.
Because the last time you were here, you left without a word of warning. How do I know you won't do it again?
You don't.
Oh. Constable, I'm so sorry I bothered you, but it's quite all right. They're back, and...
Not all of them, ma'am.
What?
You found this one out wandering in the park. Good night, ma'am.
George.
Where is she?
Miss Andrew?
She left.
Left? But how?
She might have thought we were rude.
Rude? To Miss Andrew? Well, I can't forget it, but I'll certainly try to forget. In fact, give me the old sixpence before I had it.
George, you haven't noticed. Mary Poppins is back.
Mary Poppins. Hi, we have a word. There's no point in being out of the bush. I haven't been well since you left.
About my wages, sir. If you don't mind, I shouldn't take any just now. I should prefer to let them accrue.
Mary Poppins, if you only knew how many payments we're accruing as it is.
Is everything all settled?
It is. Now, I must get started. Jane, Michael, Spitzbot. Are the drains playing up, or is Mrs. Bro cooking?
Come along, darling. You've made a wrong decision, but how bad is that? After so many years of good service, what's the worst that can happen?
Winifred, having to be dismissed from the bank would be a total destitute. Servants will leave, the house we repossess. Maybe we'd be out with the children on the frosty curbside.
But we'll still have what really matters, the children and each other.
Another world to be unfurled. It ain't just myths and fables. A chimney stack. cold and black against the twilight sky. But never fear, there's warmth up here. Perhaps you'll find out why.
What do I look like? Ah, that's better.
The world is awfully big, isn't it?
And what does that tell you?
That we're awfully small and unimportant.
Oh, speak for yourself.
Not us so much, as our troubles. They seem so big down in the nursery, but up here...
That's more like it. Troubles are never so bad when you look at them from a little higher up. And always remember, there's plenty of folk right to help you should you need them.
Who?
Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim tree. Now guardian angels, you don't often see. They're not highfalutin, not grand nor aloof. They're covered in soot, and they're up on your roof.
Chim chimney, chim chim tree.
See? It's true.
Brush away the dirt and soot.
Brush away your tears.
Cobwebs that are swept away.
Around for years.
In all weathers of all lives, we can see for miles. Our ideal of heaven is a night out of the stars. We may look a muddy
world, the muddy world. Thank you. shout it louder.
Stop in time.
Step, 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 step.
What is this? What is all this?
Special delivery,
Esquire.
Special delivery? Special delivery, step in time. Special delivery, step in time. Time to go, good night, Gunga!
Not so fast. Upstairs now. Jane, you too. Mary Poppins, would you be good enough to explain this?
Well,
yes?
I never explain anything. Come along, children.
What's happened? Chairman wants to see me at close of business. Tonight.
Tonight? Well, I'm going to come with you and jolly well give your chairman a piece of my mind.
I'm afraid that'll only make matters worse, my dear. Might as well face it. In a matter of hours, I would have joined the ranks with unemployed.
George, are you quite sure?
Quite sure. In fact, I think the time has come.
Your mother's vase? Won't you miss it terribly?
Needs must, my dear. I've always said we'll save it for a rainy day. Looks like tomorrow it's set to pour.
George, do be careful.
They hit a loop!
Mrs. Brill, let's go into the kitchen, shall we? You'd better sit down.
Mrs. Brill, is that the dinner cookie?
Don't you start. I've already opened up all the windows.
I was only going to say it smells delicious.
The whole world has gone upside down.
Well, I never. So that's right, Boylan.
What are they?
Stars. Gingerbread stars, I had for my nanny once. I always knew I put them somewhere no one would ever find them. The trouble was, I couldn't find them either.
They're very bright.
Aren't they? And after all this time.
Here, let me give you a hand.
I always dream I learned everything there is to know about the stars. Funny, I haven't thought about that in all this time.
It's good to look back sometimes.
Is it? Not sure. A man has dreams of walking with giants, to carve his niche in the edifice of time, before the mortar of his zeal has a chance to congeal. The cup is dashed from his lips. The flame is snuffed to burning. He's brought to wreck and ruin in his prime.
Life's a rum go, Governor, and that's the truth.
You know what I think? Mary Poppins. Ever since she stepped in this house, things began to happen to me. My world was calm, well-ordered, exemplary. Then came this person with chaos in her wake. And now my life ambitions go with one foul blow. It's quite a bitter pill to take. Is that Poppins a win?
She's responsible for all of this. I know the very person. What's that thing she's always saying? A spoonful of sugar, that is all that it takes. It changes bread and water into tea and cakes. A spoonful of sugar goes a long, long way. So have yourself a healthy helping every day. Healthy helping in trouble, you ask me. It's like you say, Gunther. You've got to grind, grind, grind at that grindstone. Though childhood slips like sand through a sieve, then all too soon they've up and grown, and then they've flown, and it's too late for you to give just that spoonful of sugar to help the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Well, good luck, Gunther.
Thank you, Bert. Good luck to you, too.
Father?
What is it?
We've come to say goodnight.
Ah, yes. Goodnight.
Daddy?
What is it?
Remember when we went to the bank? We were each given a sixpence and told to spend them wisely.
Excellent advice. That's exactly what you should do. What did you buy with them?
Nothing yet. We kept them, and now we've decided to give them to you.
Suppose Mary Poppins put you up to this.
No, she hasn't said a word about it since. But we just know it's been difficult for you lately, and we haven't been much help.
So we thought a little bit of extra cash might loosen things up a bit.
It's a whole shilling.
Thank you.
Good night, Daddy. We do love you, you know.
Jane?
Yes?
Do you remember when you asked me who Neelis' father was? It was Poseidon, king of the sea. Good night.
Anything can
happen if you let it. Sometimes things are difficult, but you can bet it doesn't have to be so.
Changes can be made.
You can move a mountain if you use a larger spade.
Anything can happen, it's a marvel.
You can be a butterfly
or just a larval. Stretch your mind beyond fantastic. Dreams are made of strong elastic.
Well, Banks, how did it happen? You turned down a scheme that was bound to make millions, and we want to know why.
Then I'll tell you. I refused Mr. Von Hustler because his scheme was hollow. It had no substance, had no product. It had no meaning outside the walls of a bank. Yes, he told me about the profits and the assets and the growth. There wasn't a word about people. Now, I know. Any man that puts real value on human life, as far as you're concerned, is a washout. But I'm afraid I do value it, gentlemen. In short, George Banks Esquire has rediscovered the human race. I apologize for ruining the bank, but I do not apologize for understanding that there's more important things in life than making money.
Ruin the bank? Ruin the bank? Ruin the bank, my dear chap, what are you talking about? You've saved your bacon. Haven't you heard? Von Hustler's scheme has ruined our rival. We don't want your apologies, we're offering ours.
Oh, my word.
And another thing. Do you remember giving a loan to a man named Northbrook? Well, he's repaying it and opening two new factories with the percentage you negotiated. We're set to make a fortune.
Oh, my word.
Well, that's just it. We very much hope you might tell us how you did it. Just give us the word. It'll be quite safe with us.
Give you the word? Give you the word? I'll give you the word, all right? Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Oh, thank you, sir. No, thanks.
Forgive him. It's not his fault. It's all because of his nanny, Miss Andrew.
The Holy Terror? She taught me everything I know.
Then now's your chance to forget it.
That's right, and if you want to fight about it, then you've come to the right woman.
It's quite all right, dear. I haven't lost any money at all. I've made the bank a fortune.
Really?
Gentlemen!
Madam, if you please, we still have some business to conduct.
Ah, well, thanks. George, by way of recompense, we'd like to offer you the job of senior manager, with salary at double.
Exactly. How much has he made for you?
Triple. Quadruple your present rate.
Close your mouth, George. We are not a codfish.
Well, I accept. But you must understand one thing. From now on, family comes first.
Agreed?
Agreed.
I'm afraid I've underestimated you, my dear. How can you ever forgive me?
How can you ask?
It was rude of me to kick you off the stage. You want to come back, and I won't mind if you do.
No, I loved it, but I found a role I quite rather prefer. It's going to keep me extremely busy for a very long time.
If you let it.
If you reach for the stars, all you get are the stars. But we found a hole to spin. If you reach for the heavens, you get the stars thrown you.
and some best yet. Can we up in the heavens? Will we ever go back there again?
Yes, someday.
Really? Will it be soon?
Oh no, not for a very long time. You know, you can always keep an eye on the stars until you return. You can have my telescope.
But it's yours.
It is. You can keep it if you like. It's a present.
Thank you.
Now run along, you need to. It's getting cold.
I love you, Mary Poppins.
You're a fine boy, Michael Banks, and one day you'll be a fine man.
Oh, Mary Poppins, it makes me so anxious when you talk all soft like that. Not a bit like you.
Is that the thanks I get for all the trouble I've taken?
That's better.
That's dainty, Bert.
There you are, Mary. I've given them for you. It's tonight, isn't it?
It is.
Well, goodbye, Mary.
Goodbye, Bert. Look after yourself.
Perfect, and I hope it remains so.
Something's changed. Look, the hat stand's gone.
Look, it's Mary Poppins' locket. Oh no, the chain's broken.
Don't you remember? I'll stay until the chain breaks.
There's a note, too. Michael had the telescope, so this is for you. Look, it's a picture of the three of us.
And look, she signed it. From Mary Poppins with a good deal of love.
Mary Poppins? She's gone. How peculiar.
Don't worry. She'll be back. Now, what do you think of this?
It's the best I've ever seen.
Do you think we could fly it together?
Oh, Daddy.
Mary Poppins isn't coming back. She's gone forever.
My dear, how could you possibly know such a thing?
Because we don't need her anymore. And other families will, won't they, Daddy?
Yes, they will.
I wonder if she's right. We could really do without a nanny from now on. What do you think?
You should come dance with me.
George, this is serious.
Is that a shooting star?
Here, you can use my telescope.
It was. Wish on it, children. Here's love.
We won't forget you, Mary Poppins.
We'll never forget.